Okay, so okay, very good morning all of you. So today we'll start our practical number 4. Okay. So I thought we have completed our last practical, practical number 3, that is the structural analysis. Okay, so structural analysis, we have solved one problem in our ANSYS software. Basically, we have not started our third chapter in theory. Yesterday only we have started our third chapter, that is a finite element method and automation. So in that first part we have started, and in that first part we have seen the definition of the FEM. Actually, what is the meaning of the FEM, and side by side, what are types of the analysis which are going to we are using for a particular mechanical analysis. Okay, and not only using the different types of the analysis, but we have to analyze which type of the analysis is suitable for that particular problem. Okay, that is the main role, and this is a task, difficult task to understand which type of the analysis we have to use for particular that problem. So this is your skill. So you should know which type of the analysis we have to use for the that particular problem. That is your task. Okay. So that skill you will get improved after some times. Means you have to just experiencing with software. You are handling with ANSYS, and then you will come to know. So this type of analysis is suitable for that particular problem. Okay, so that is a basically practice and practice. You should do more practice by using ANSYS. You should know well manner. Okay, so already we have completed this third practical. In that we have seen this problem number 1. So in last practical we have taken the one simple one step bar. Bar element, one dimensional bar element, and one side fixed and one side applying the force. Okay, so already we have discussed and solved the problem only on ANSYS only. Okay, so whenever in theoretical part we'll see actual the calculation of this one dimensional bar element by using the matrices. So that time we will again validate the result of this software as well as our theoretical answer. Okay, so that is the first task. So in the same structural analysis in our manual, again I have given 3 problem statement. In that first problem statement we have completed, no problem. Okay, so this is the second problem. The same way you have to just follow the procedure given by the manual. So this is the second problem with a tapered bar. Okay, not a straight bar. You can see here, this is the tapered bar problem, which is having length 3 to 5 meter. And the area of cross section for the first region, that's 1000 mm² and 500 mm² for the second region. This is A2, which is a tapered side. And Young's modulus value is a 2 × 10⁵ Newton per mm square. Okay, so as per the given values, you have to modify the all the dimensions either in mm or either in meter. Okay, so ek tar tumhi sagle dimension eka kutla tari unit madhe convert kara. As per your convenience, you can keep as a meter as a millimeter. Okay, so this is one thing. So we are not going to see this problem. If you are interested to solve this problem, whenever after the completion of this all the practicals, then I will go for the remaining problems. If possible, if you are having a laptop, your own laptop, then you can install the ANSYS software. Already I have in last practical I told you the procedure to install and download the ANSYS setup. Okay, so this will be seen in at the last. So we'll start today our practical number 4, that is experiment number 4, that is depends on the solution of the thermal analysis 2-dimensional problem using the ANSYS. Okay, so today we are going to see a thermal analysis problem. Okay, so now you can see here In the major thermal analysis, we have to see some major parameter like thermal analysis calculates the temperature distribution. So that is a temperature distribution. Okay, so not only we are going to conduct the just analysis, but we have to identify in which portion we got the maximum temperature value distribution. So that value we have to find out through this analysis. That is the most important part. Okay. So you can see here. I think my screen is visible to you. Okay. So and the related thermal quantities. Related thermal quantities means whatever other constant like amount of the heat lost, gained, thermal gradients, then thermal fluxes. That all the four parameters we have to calculate from this analysis for given condition like one wall is given and either one side wall temperature, that is the initial temperature, room temperature, and other side wall temperature is a, we have to given from the problem statement, that is a higher temperature. And in between this wall, we have to calculate intermediate temperature from this given thermal analysis by using our formulation. Okay, so that is our task. So we will see how to calculate and where we have to put the formulas. That things we will see in our theoretical lecture section. So this is a thermal simulation plays important role in the design of the many engineering application. So actually, thermal engineering is a very, very important role in our industry, like manufacturing industry, designing engineering, mechanical, overall the mechanical or automobile sector industry. It plays a very, very vital role because we have to analyze, we have to find out the different effects from the surrounding as well as the nature when before launching the any vehicle on the market, because in all respect we have to check the conditions, then variables of that particular vehicles. आपण ज्यावेळेस एखादी गाडी मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग करतो, ती गाडी कस्टमरला सेल करणार, आपल्याला ती गाडी ईच अँड एव्हरी कंडिशन वी हॅव टू व्हॅलिडेट, आपल्याला ती गाडी सगळ्या कंडिशन मधून चेक करावं लागते. ठीक आहे, त्याच्यावरती टेस्टिंग करावं लागतं आणि नंतरच त्याच्यावरती आपल्याला पुढची प्रोसेस करता येते. म्हणजे कसं, सपोज तुम्ही आपली टू व्हीलर घेतली किंवा फोर व्हीलर घेतली, थंडीच्या दिवसामध्ये सकाळी चालू होत नाही, बरोबर आहे. काय होतं त्यामध्ये, इंजिन मध्ये जे काय ऑइल पोर्शन असतं तो काय होतो, तो खाली सक होऊन एका ठिकाणी येऊन घट्ट बसतो. ठीक आहे, तुम्ही ज्यावेळेस सकाळी सकाळी गाडी चालू करायला जातो त्यावेळेस ते ऑइल जाम झालेलं असतं. ते सुरुवातीला जर तुम्ही लूज केलं, म्हणजे किक मारून जर इंजिन मध्ये गिअर मधून ते खालतीवरती झालं तर ते लूज होतं आणि नंतर गाडी चालवायला मदत होती. परंतु तुम्ही विदाऊट किक मारता किंवा डायरेक्ट स्टार्टरला क्लिक केलं तर गाडी सकाळी लवकर चालू होत नाही. ठीक आहे, तो सेम वे वी हॅव टू चेक ऑल दी वेदर कंडिशन एज वेल एज ऑल दी अदर बाउंड्री कंडिशन on that particular vehicle before launching the vehicle, and depending on that different conditions, we are just making some system manual or that particular vehicle manual to handle this vehicle in this way. So for that purpose we have to check all the important parameter, like in summer days the temperature will be more, okay, regarding that our room temperature. So that temperature is affecting on the our vehicle. Is there any changes in the internal part or external part of the vehicle? So for that purpose we are going to provide some heat exchanger, any other terms on the our engine surrounding, okay, so minimizing the heat reactions on that particular surfaces, in front surfaces as well as the above of that engine we are providing some fins, okay, in near of the spark plugs. So we have to just remove the heat throughout this engine part. Because of that we are going to provide the fins. So like this way we have to do the analysis before actual manufacturing of the engine part. So we in that ANSYS software we are going to do analysis and we are providing some temperature, like surrounding temperature, above that surrounding temperature we can take the example of the 80 degree Celsius, also 100 degree, 200, 500, 700, and we are going to just analyze whether that engine casing and engine is working in a good condition or not. Okay, so that type of the analysis we have to check in this thermal analysis. Okay, so here applications we can say in many engineering application like internal combustion engines, already I have taken the example right now, turbines, then heat exchangers, then piping system, electronic components. So in many cases, engineers follows the thermal analysis with a stress analysis, calculate the thermal stresses. म्हणजे हे जे काही सगळे ऍप्लिकेशन आहेत त्याच्यामध्ये सगळे इंजिनियर काय करतात, हे टेस्टिंग करून अनालिसिस करून चेक करतात. अँड इफ दॅट रिझल्ट इज अंडर अवर कन्सिडरेशन, देन यू कॅन फॉरवर्ड दिस डिझाईन टू द मॅन्युफॅक्चरिंग. ओके, सो लाईक दिस वे. सो टाइप्स ऑफ द थर्मल अनालिसिस यू कॅन सी इन दॅट फर्स्ट इज स्टडी, सेकंड इज अ अनस्टडी. ओके, सो यू कॅन सी स्टडी, इन दॅट स्टडी वी आर गोइंग टू सी डिफरंट डिफरंट कंडिशन्स. लाईक वाईज सेम इन सेकंड ट्रान्झिट थर्मल अनालिसिस. सो वील सी direct our first problem, that is a problem number 1, thermal analysis problem with a conduction problem for a single wall. ata apan fakt kay kartoy, two dimension cha problem ghetoy jithe ek single bhint ahe, tya bhintiche apan ek analysis kartoy thermal analysis. tyachya madhe apan kontye kontye parameter ahet baka. aple aim kay ahe, determine the heat flux and nodal temperature of a single wall. apan heat flux kadaycha ani tyacha nodal temperature aplyala find karaycha. problem description kay baka, the inner surface of the plain brick wall is at 60 degrees Celsius and the outer surface is 35 degrees Celsius. tumhala atlya bajucha ani baherchya bajucha surface temperature dilela ahe 60 degree and 35 degree. okay, so calculate the rate of heat transfer. we have to calculate the rate of the heat transfer per meter square of surface area, and which is surface area wall thickness is 220 mm, and the temperature constant K is equal to 0.51 watt per meter. okay, so we will see and we will solve this problem on analysis first, and after that we will solve this problem on theoretical also with our formulation. okay, so this is the steps for the procedure of the FEM experiment, today's experiment, that is a thermal analysis experiment. okay, so first step is a preference, general steps already we have seen in our FEM general steps in our theoretical lecture. so first is a pre-processing, then processing, and last is the post-processing. okay, so in that pre-processing, this first part is element type. so because first of all we have to select the actually analysis type, so we will select the first our analysis type. so I just now just we can see here ANSYS workbench window is there. so this is our preference tab. we can click the preference tab, we can select our analysis type. we are today we are going to see the thermal analysis. so click just thermal on and click on the OK button. once you click on the OK, our thermal analysis tab will be active. so now next procedure is the pre-processing. you can click on the pre-processing. now you can see first is element type. okay, so first of all we have to add the element type. from the given problem statements we have to draw the diagram. okay, so please keep in mind, otherwise you can just open in your mobile that lab manual, you can see the procedure of that the same. I will just explain the ANSYS, you will be understand. okay, so first point is element type. just click on the element type tab, then go add, edit, delete button. then you can see here the we have to define the element type. ओके, सुरुवातीला आपल्याला काय करायचंय, कोणतंही ड्रॉइंग काढताना त्या ड्रॉइंगचं इलिमेंट टाइप डिफाईन करायचं, दॅट इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हॅव टू डिफाईन द मटेरियल इलिमेंट टाइप, क्लिक ऑन द ऍड बटन. नाव यू कॅन सी हियर देर आर डिफरंट टाइप ऑफ द इलिमेंट इज देअर. सो इन दॅट वी हॅव टू सिलेक्ट द लिंक इलिमेंट. सो क्लिक ऑन द लिंक इलिमेंट अँड इन फ्रंट ऑफ द यू कॅन सी हियर कंडक्शन, ओके, कन्वेक्शन अँड रॅडिएशन. सो वी हॅव टू गो फॉर द विच प्रॉब्लेम, you can just see here, this is the problem of the the conduction itself, given the its problem is on the depends on the conduction. so we have to select the conduction, thermal analysis problem with conduction problem for single wall. okay, so we have to select the here add link and conduction, and then click on the okay button. you can see here element type is appearing, type one is a link 33, then you can close, then go to the real constant, click on the real constant, then add, edit, delete. now you can see click on the add button, then link 33 is added, click on the okay button, and then constant number 1 and area, area of cross section is I think already given. Okay, so we have to just enter the one value, 1 meters per square. Then click on the OK button, close. So first pre-processing element type is defined, then real constant, that is a area of cross section, is also given. So next is material properties. Click on the material properties, go to the material models, click on the material models. Now you can see material model. We are going to see thermal analysis, so click on the thermal, again go to the conductivity, then isotropic and orthotropic. So we have to go for the isotropic. We are considering whole thing is only one, so isotropic. Click on the isotropic, click on the KXX constant, and that which is given, that is a 0.51 watt per meter. Okay, and just click on the OK button and exit. So already we have given the area of cross section, then material thermal conductivity value K, then go for the modeling. Now we have to model the actual part. Okay, modeling, then click on the create button. Through the nodes, so we are going to create the entity and in active coordinate system. आता आपल्याला काय करायचे, ज्योमेट्री ड्रॉ करायची आहे थ्रू दी कॉर्डिनेट्स. आता पहिला नोड नंबर देतो मी याला सिक्वेन्स 1, आणि त्याच्यामध्ये एक्स कॉर्डिनेट किती आहेत 0, अगेन वाय कॉर्डिनेट 0, ओके, झेड नाही, आपण टू डायमेन्शनल घेतोय, बघा त्यामुळे तिसऱ्या डायमेन्शनची व्हॅल्यू येत नाही. ओके, देन सेकंड पॉइंट 0.22 already given in your manual. I'm not just entering any values. You can refer the manual, FEM manual. In that manual, already coordinates is given. Y coordinate also 0. Then click on the, this is a rotational moment. So click on the apply button. This is the first point. Again, I will create the second point. For second point, X value is 0.22 and Y value 0. And click on the okay button. So now you can see here is the second point, this is the first point. Two nodes is created, so I will join this entity. So create, again create, then I will join this element to the elements, then element attributes. You can see here link, element type is the material. Okay, two nodes, one button is there. Okay, drawing is completed. So next part is loads, define loads. Due to some license issue, our Ansys is stopped working. So give me 1 minute, I will start again. So this is not a license copy. So that's why in between our software is not working properly. So try to understand. We have to start it again from the start to end. Reprocessing, then again, element type, add edit, add link, conduction, apply, okay. Okay. Okay, material properties, Okay, right now I'm audible. Okay, sorry for disturbance due to some problem. Okay, so we'll start again. So okay, we have here. So we have to select these two nodes. Okay, and applying the temperature. So for second node, temperature is 35 degree. You click on the okay button. So already I have given the boundary condition and loading condition for this particular problem. Okay, so this is a two sentence and two points which is given, inner side temperature and outside temperature, that is a 35 degree and 60 degree. Okay, so already we have created the geometry as well as we have given the all the boundary conditions. So now you can see here. Okay, so next point is we have to go for the solution, our second last step, solution, then analysis type, then we have to go for the new analysis, and we have to select the steady state and okay button, because we are going to conduct the steady analysis. And last is a solve button, which is our last post processing steps. We have to select the current LS and we have to click. You can see here one window is appearing on the screen, that is a solution of the current load step is review the summary. So we have to just click on the OK button. Now you can again see one more window is appearing, that is the solution is done. That means your analysis is completely done. You can see close on the button, and now you can see this is a solution option windows. You can see here the problem statement, then degrees of freedom, then problem load, given the load step number, then end step number, then number of the sub step. Okay, so once you got this analysis done, is that means your solution is solved. You can close this problem and go to general post procedure last step, that is a plot the result, and go to the control plot, nodal solution, degrees of freedom solution, then nodal temperature, and click on the OK button. Now you can see here this is the graph where you can easily understand. Easily understand the color graph. Okay, so maximum value of the temperature, how that vary from the point number one to point number two. Okay, so this is actually result of this. Here you can see maximum stress is 60, minimum 35, and substep 1. Okay, and the temperature values from the maximum to minimum. Here side log point number one la 60 degree dilo hota, point number two la 35 डिग्री दिलं होतं, त्याच्यामुळे मॅक्झिमम कलर रेड आहे तो या 60 साईडला आहे, आणि तो इथं व्हॅरी व्हॅरी कमी होत, तो सेंटरला कमी झाला, आणि ह्या साईडवरून परत ब्ल्यू साईडला बघा, इथून 35 डिग्री अप्लाय केलं होतं, इथं पण थोडा ब्ल्यू आहे, आणि इथून परत हा कलर चेंज होतोय. ठीक आहे, सो दिस इज द वन थिंग. देन अगेन यू कॅन गो लिस्ट रिझल्ट हिअर, बट ड्यू टू सम अगेन सम सॉफ्टवेअर इश्यू, अगेन नाव कॅन सी हिअर software is not working properly, again one message is coming on the screen. So again we have to go for the repeat procedure. Okay, so no problem. So only I want to tell you, just after the all the calculation from the processing steps, you have to go for the last step, that is a, you can see here, general processing, general post processing. In that you have to go for the plot result, in that counter plot, then nodal solution. Once you complete the nodal solution, go for the final result, click on the list result. Okay, here list result, and you can go for the which temperature point you want to calculate. You can just select that at temperature point, you will get the intermediate temperature value also. Okay, so again we'll see, don't worry. Okay, preference, thermal analysis, okay. Preprocessor element type, add elite element, add link, okay, close. Then real constant, add edit, add, okay. Area one, click on the okay button, then close. Then material properties, material models, thermal, conductivity, isotropy, 0.51, okay. Click, then go to the modeling, create to the nodes in active CS, first node 0, 0, apply, second node 0.22, click on the OK. Now you can see, then go to the create, then element, element attribute, click on the OK button, then atom number, two nodes, pick the first node, second node, apply, okay. Okay, then loads, define loads, loads, define loads, apply, thermal, temperature on nodes, select the first, apply, temperature constant value 60 degree, then click on the OK button, then select, apply, second nodes, apply, degree 35, select the OK. Then go to the solution, then analysis type, then new analysis, study, OK, solve, current ALS, OK, solution is done, then general post processing, then plot result, counter plot, nodal solution, degrees of freedom, nodal temperature, click on the OK button. Then again go list result, in that list results, nodal load, nodal loads, you can see here heat flow, click on the OK button. Now you can see here the actual result, whatever we want, you can see here one window is coming, load step one, load sub step one, time is required only 1 second, load case zero, node पहिल्या पॉइंटला, ओके, नोड पॉइंटला वनला किती आपला कॅल्क्युलेट काय करायचं होतं, क्वेश्चन काय होता आपला, सो टू डिटरमाइन द हीट फ्लक्स अँड नोडल टेम्परेचर ऑफ द सिंगल वॉल, इज इट करेक्ट, येस, सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट हीट फ्लक्स व्हॅल्यू ऍट नोड वन, -57.9.55 किलो वॅट पर मीटर स्क्वेअर, अँड सेकंड इज 57+955, सेम व्हॅल्यू विथ ओनली सिग्नेचर व्हॅल्यूज मायनस अँड प्लस, ओके, दिस इज द हीट फ्लक्स व्हॅल्यू अँड actual temperature for that already given, 60 degree at 0.1 and 35 degree at 0.2, okay, is it correct? So this way you have to calculate the all the values, okay. So you can see here a list of result, detailed experiment, detailed value also is there, introduction summary is there. Whatever you want, you can see your percentage error also. Okay, like nodal solution is there. If you want to other thermal gradient value in x-axis also, you can just click on value. You will get again x-axis values. If you want to go the y-axis value, hit thermal flux value. You can just click and you will get the all the values. This is the benefit of this ANSYS in terms of the thermal analysis. So whatever you want, any we can call as a result from the in your VIs, you can just select the that particular value and you can just what the result. Okay, so this is the one of the simple example of the our current thermal analysis two dimensional. So I will show one video for the our the next problem. So you can just see complete the see the completely problems, and whenever you try to solve on the ANSYS, you will get the complete idea regarding that the same. So I will show. Okay, so now you can just see this is one of the problem.
How to do thermal analysis in ANSYS.
All the this is information is given in the problem statement, and you can see.
As you can see, we have a rectangular block of 100 by 150 meters, and the coefficient of thermal conductivity of the material is 50 watt per meter square degree centigrade. In this problem, we are not going to consider the effect of convection. We are going to see only conduction effect on this block. Now let us perform a thermal analysis on this problem. First of all, go to preferences. These are the different modules which are available in ANSYS. As we are going to do thermal analysis, I'm going to select thermal. Okay. Go to preprocessor, element type, add element. As we are going to consider rectangular block, I'm going to select this solid. These are the different solids which are available for thermal analysis. I'm going to go with quad 4 node 55. Okay, close. As this is single material, I'm no real constants are not going to consider. Then go to material properties, material models, thermal conductivity, isotropic. In the given question, we have the coefficient of thermal conductivity as 50. So I'm going to select this 50. Okay, sorry. 50. Okay. Close. Now let us start modeling. Modeling. Create areas. Rectangle. By two corners. I'm going to take origin. Width of the rectangle is 100 meters and height is 150. While modeling it, be careful that all the units are in single form as ANSYS doesn't recognize any unit. Okay. Now we got the rectangle. Now let us mesh it. Go for meshing. You can either mesh by using mesh tool or directly use mesh option from here. I'm going to select mesh here. Mesh the areas. As the rectangle is uniform, I'm going to select mapped mesh. Mapped three or four sided. I'm going to select this area. Okay. As you can see, the mesh you have got is very coarse. But we want more final mesh so that we can get more accurate results. So let us modify this mesh. Modify mesh. Refine it. We have to refine this mesh at every single line. So I'm going to select lines. As we are going to refine this mesh at every line, I'll select pick all. This shows different levels of refinement. I'm going to select intermediate refinement, that is 3. Okay. Now you can see that this mesh is refined. Now we have to give loads. before that we have to check if this analysis is the steady state or thermal transient or any substructuring. So as this problem is under steady state condition, we are going to select steady state analysis. Okay, now we have to define loads. Define loads, apply thermal, temperature on lines. We'll once again go to the problem statement. These two four phases have different temperatures like 300, 200, 200 and 100. So now we are going to apply thermal loads on individual phases respectively. Select this one. This has a temperature of 300 degrees centigrade. Temperature 300. Okay. Now these two phases have same temperature, I'm going to select them simultaneously. 200. Okay. Lines. This one has 100 degrees centigrade. This is 100. Okay. Now you can see that there are different thermal loads applied here. The next thing we are going to do is solving. As there is no effect of convection, I'm directly going for solution. Solution. Solve. Current load state. Okay. The solution is done. Now you can see your results either from list results or also plot results. Go to general post processor. You can see the values of the solution by list results, nodal solution, degrees of freedom solution, nodal temperature. In this you can see the variation of temperature from phase 2 to phase 3. Okay. Then I have nodal solution, nodal temperature. Okay, see this is the variation of temperature from left side to right side. If you want to see it in a pictorial form or plot results, you go to plot results, control plot, nodal solution, degrees of freedom solution, nodal temperature. See, this is the variation of temperature from this phase 2 to phase 3. The temperature is maximum here. This is obviously 300 degrees centigrade. It goes on decreasing here. It increases and also then decreases to the bottom. Now if you want to see the variation of temperature with respect to certain path, then go to path operations, define a path by nodes. As we have done a refinement in mesh, these are the nodes which are available replaced like this. You plot the nodes like this so that you can see the nodes clearly and get variation of temperature with respect to nodes. I'm going to let us see the select these nodes first. Let us name this as temperature. Okay, close. Now go to map onto path, temperature. Okay, now plot path on graph. Select this temperature one. Okay, this is the variation of temperature with respect to that. I didn't select the middle one exactly, so this is not exactly symmetric. If you select the middle one, you're going to get symmetric. You can define new path or any select any nodes on which you want to get temperature. This is the thermal analysis of the rectangular block. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.
Okay, so understood. So this is a way to just calculate and just plot the graph. If you want to the intermediate surfaces within the any valve, you can take any example of the thermal analysis. Suppose you are interested only some nodes or some area of that problem, You can just go to here on the plot. You can select the plot. You can just select the specific nodes, and you can just plot the graph. So like this way, you have just go. You have a lot of option. You have a lot of choices. If you want to draw a specific any analysis, specific any results from the current problem, you can do anything. You can see here a lot of options. Lot of tools is there. Once you open the software, once you try to using the software, you come to know there are a lot of tools you can use as per your requirement. Okay, suppose if you want to draw a specific in x-axis temperature and distance in y-axis, and you want to draw the graph for the whole the problem, you can select all the nodes and you can draw the graph temperature variation without with the distance. Okay, you will get the all the values. So this is the one thing. So now, okay, so we will see a second problem. Okay, so I will just, okay, so this is the first problem of the thermal analysis. Now I will show you second problem. So now you can see this is again second problem of the thermal analysis, solution of the thermal analysis problem using ANSYS to determine the heat flux and nodal temperature. So now the change is only that one word is a composite valve. Composite valve means there are again two type of the material combined with the that plane valve. Not only one type of the material, in that composite valve maybe two or more than two. Okay, so we will see one by one. So you can see here a reactor valve 320 mm thick is made up of an inner layer, a fire brick of the 114.6 mm, which is having thermal conductivity is 0.84 watt per meter, covered with a layer of the insulation is a 205.4 mm, which is having thermal conductivity K is equal to 0.16 watt per meter Celsius, and the reactor operates at the temperature of 1235 degrees Celsius, and the ambient temperature, that is a room temperature, is 25 degrees Celsius. ओके याच्यामध्ये तुम्हाला कळालं असेल जो ब्रिकचा आहे त्याचं डायमेन्शन त्याचं थर्मल कंडक्टिव्हिटी ते व्हॅल्यू दिलेली आहे आणि इन्सुलेशन जे आहे जे दोन्हीमध्ये दोन मटेरियलच्या ते आहे ते त्याचं सेपरेट ठीक आहे थिकनेस दिलेली आहे थर्मल कंडक्टिव्हिटीचे व्हॅल्यू दिलेले आहे आणि ओव्हरऑल रिएक्टरचं टेम्परेचर दिलेलं आहे आणि रूम टेम्परेचर पण दिलेलं आहे ठीक आहे तर याच्यावरून आपल्याला काढायचं काय हिट फ्लक्स आणि नोडल टेम्परेचर ते पहिल्या इनर लेअरला आणि इन्सुलेशनला ह्या दोन वेगवेगळ्या ठिकाणी टेम्परेचर किती असेल ठीक आहे तर परत सेम प्रोसिजर वी हॅव टू जस्ट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हॅव टू क्लोज ऑल दिस वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू सेव्ह इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सेव्ह सो क्वाइट नो सेव्ह सिलेक्ट अँड क्लिक ऑन द कॅन्सल बटन अगेन आय विल जस्ट ओपन द ANSYS Okay, so preference, again select the thermal, click on the OK button, preprocessor, then again click on the element type, add edit, add, define, then link, then click on the OK button, then real constant, add edit, add, OK, then area of cross section is 1. काही दिलेलं नसेल तर 1 टाकायचं युनिट ओके ओके क्लिक देन मटेरियल मॉडेल्स देन थर्मल कंडक्टिव्हिटी आयसोट्रॉपिक द व्हॅल्यू गिवन फ्रॉम द प्रॉब्लेम 0.84 वॅट पर मीटर स्क्वेअर पर मीटर पर डिग्री सेल्सियस देन मटेरियल न्यू मॉडेल isotropic, then define material, 1-dimensional, variable, wait. I think I'm missing one step in between this. So after that material models, already we applied the 0.84 watt meter. And again, material library, then new model. I just remembering, give me 1 minute. Material, new model. Again, thermal, again, conductivity, isotropic, one-dimensional. Okay, new element, okay, define, add edit, add, then one dimensional, that is a link. Two, okay, then material model, material properties, material models, again isotropic. For the second value, again we have to go for the add one more here, add T2. I want to add actually the second material model, isotropic, but define one dimensional already material. Okay. So right now I will understand. Just give me 1 minute. Whatever already I have created material, that once I want to repeat it, no problem. Then go to the material properties, then material models. Here material, new model, define material ID 2. Okay. And for that 2, I want to give specific values. That is the second material. The insulation values, that is 0.16. okay, palaka kay kele te ita baka don zalet, material 1, material 2. Material 1 manje te tumcha inner material layer cha, ani material 2 manje tumche insulation. Theek aahe, he don zala. Next is modeling, then create nodes in active CS, then first node number, that is 00. Okay, 00. Then click on the apply. Then again, second point, which is having point X at the point 1146, which is already given in your manual. I am not just entering anything. Again, third point values is 0.32, Y coordinate 0, and click on the OK button. So our 3 points element points nodes is already created. So create, then elements, element attributes. Click on the OK, atom number, through nodes, pick. OK. First, elements, element attributes. Then OK, atom numbered, through nodes, select the first node, second node. Okay, then again click the attributes. Then okay, atom number, select the node number 2 and 3, click on the okay. Check. Then loads. Then define loads. Apply thermal, then temperature on nodes, select the first node, apply temperature. Ye jo bahar se temperature aaye the kitne hota 1325, click on the apply button. then again select the node 3 je outside cha hota te apply ani temperature kiti hota te 25 je tumcha ambient temperature ahe te click on the okay doni bajuche temperature apply kelele ahe and go to the solution then analysis type new analysis steady state okay then solve current ALS okay solution is done general post procedure then plot result counter plot nodal solution degrees of freedom nodal temperature click on the okay ivaga nodal temperature ala je ka apna apply kele hote tyacha value variation alele ahet then list result then nodal loads heat flow click on the okay button e baga node 1 la heat flux kiti value ali minus 3412.5 and node 3 la 3412.5 theek hai he tumchi load chi heat flux chi value theek hai ani he sodun tumhala jar ajun te je dusre result have astil tar ithe baga list result madhe nodal solution ahe thermal gradient ahe त्याच्यामध्ये एक्स एक्सिस ला कंपोनेंटचा असेल तर तो तुम्हाला कॅल्क्युलेट करता येईल नसेल तर हे थर्मल फ्लक्स आहे वाय डायरेक्शन एक्स डायरेक्शन ठीक आहे आणि मगाशी जसं त्यांनी सांगितलं प्लॉट रिझल्ट तुम्हाला जर नोडचे हवे असतील तर ते मी तुम्ही नोडचे काढून घेऊ शकता ठीक आहे सो दिस इज अवर सेकंड प्रॉब्लेम इन दी थर्मल अनालिसिस सो नाव वी विल मूव टुवर्ड्स अवर I think we have left the first one dimensional structure analysis problem second and third problem so we'll see second and third problem so before moving that first and second problem I want to show you that first analysis and you can just see this video okay And then you will understood
so easy to set up and use and integrate into your daily life whether you're a student or your work
analysis for your flat plate with a centerfold TDL and then click on and then in the license you give and accordingly save the file. This is done for the output you keep it minimized And then this is the actual window where you're going to do the analysis.
So this
so
is
before
the
starting
problem
the analysis,
of
I will tell you these are the utility menu,
okay.
which is helpful
so
to analyze the problem. Similarly, these are the options or the
video,
menus which is available.
And after the completion of this video, I will again show you how to solve the first structural problem. I will solve. Okay. So just see.
Well, with the plate, as it's called as main menu, and then these are the options. We call it as the user control menus. So now. The problem so what is the given problem we are going to see here is a flat plate with a center hole and it is having a uniform thickness when you are applying a load at one end what happens to the plate so we are considering it as the plate as a fixed end on the other side so it is like a cantilever beam so one end is fixed the other end is free so you are applying the load at one end and the other end is fixed so due to that how the deflection has been taking place due to the deflection how does the stress has been taking place So that's what you're going to see here. How does the stress is taking place, as well as how does the strain is been taking place, with respect to your stress concentration factor, and in the governing equation used here as the von Mises stress equations. So now, approaching the problem, first we have to know what are the options are available in main menu. So we are going to mainly use the four options. The first one is preference, preprocessor, solution, general postprocessor. So preference is nothing but either we are going to do a structural static analysis or fluid flow analysis or thermal analysis so here I'm going to do the structural analysis so I go to preference and click on structural and click okay so once preference is done go to preprocessor element type add element so just go to add and then click solid 8 node 183 so why we are using solid is all about because we are going to analyze your flat plate so flat plate is nothing but having a solid element so that's why we are going to just put a solid and then 8 node 183 is like 8 nodes and then 183 is the element area of the particular nodal points So then click OK. Then go to options and click the element behavior K3 as plain stress with thickness, because we are going to assume the thickness is constant. So just give it as plain stress with thickness and click OK. And then close dialog box. Then go to real constants and click on add, edit or delete, and then click add plain 183. Just type, give the element type as plain 183, click OK. Then give the thickness as value of 0.5, which is assumed again. So this is your uniform thickness throughout the plate, and click OK. Then close this dialog box. Then go to material properties. So again, material properties, depending upon the Poisson's ratio and then the Young's modulus, any material we can able to choose. So either it can be aluminum alloy or titanium alloy or carbon fiber reinforced polymers or Kevlar carbon. So whatever the material you want to choose, you can able to give the material properties of that particular material, and we can able to analyze over here. So go to material properties and click on material models. After clicking on material models, go to structural, linear, elastic, and then isotropic. So where the material properties are same in all the directions, so we go with respect to isotropic. And give, and here I'm considering the material properties aluminum alloy. So I just give it as the Young's modulus is 70 gigapascal, 70 e power 09. So I just give it as 70 gigapascal. So giga stands for 0.9, e power 09. So Poisson's ratio is 0.33, and click OK. Then close this dialog box. Don't forget to close the dialog box. If you're not closing this dialog box, again you will be facing some problems. So make sure that you close this dialog box. After closing the dialog box, go to modeling. So where you have to make a rectangular plate. So go to modeling, create, okay, areas by rectangle, and then clicking by two corner points, give the x coordinate as 0 and then the y coordinate also 0, then width as 100. So the rectangular plate width is 100, we are assuming it as, and then the height is 50. So this will make a rectangular plate over here. So we got the width as 100 and then the height as 50, and this particular origin point as 0,0. So now we want to make a center hole. To make a center hole, we need to know the center point. So it's just basic mathematics, that is like your coordinate system. So we have to get the center point over here, and we have to get the center point over here, that is like your centroid. So width divided by 2 and height divided by 2, we will be getting the centroid. And with respect to the centroid, if you draw a circle with a diameter of 10 or radius of 10 centimeter, then we can able to get the circle of it. So just go to circle, solid circle, and then click your x value as 100 divided by 2, that is 50, and your y value 50 divided by 2, 25, and then the radius of the circle we just take it as 10. Then click OK. So now we can able to see the circle has been created. So we have two areas over here. The first area is a rectangle area, and the second one is nothing but your circle. After the circle has been created, just go to operate under the modeling options and click on booleans, subtract areas. So we have to subtract the two areas. The first area is nothing but the rectangle minus the smaller one. So first we have to click this rectangle, it will turn it as pink color, then click apply, then select the inner circle, so the second area, and then click OK. Now you can able to see that the subtraction has done, the boolean operation has been done properly. So you can able to see that the first area minus the second area, we get a hollow hole over here. So this is what we required for the modeling of a simple rectangular plate with a center hole. Then go to meshing and then go to mesh tool. So what is meshing? So meshing is all about, you are meshing the entire plate with respect to your nodal points. So since it is a FPA package, finite element analysis, we know the nodal points helps to capture the stress concentration factors. So more the number of nodal points, we'll be getting more accurate results. Lesser the number of nodal points, we'll be getting less accurate results. So to get more number of accurate results, like we have to go with respect to higher number of nodal points. To go with respect to higher number of nodal points, again, you have to purchase the licensed version, and then the system configuration should be high for that. Okay. So now we are using the student version. So we have only limited with respect to 32,000 number of nodes. So we cannot able to go beyond that. So we are restricting within 32,000 number of nodes. Okay. So now we have this rectangular plate. We are going to mesh this entire rectangular plate. So to mesh this entire rectangular plate, first I go to lines, set, and set all the outer lines and click apply. Then give the number of element divisions. How much the number of element divisions I want. So I just let it be 50 as simple as possible. Then I just give 50. Okay, so this entire line has been split down into 50 smaller elements. So similarly, the vertical and the horizontal, all the four lines have been split down into individual elements. So individual 50 elements. Now we have to make the same thing for this inner circle also, because wherever there is unsymmetrical shapes, for example, arbitrary shapes over there. So over there we have to capture with respect to more number of nodal points. So in that case, we have to give more number of nodal points over here. So again, click on mesh tools and click on lines. Select this circle. Click OK and give here, instead of 50, I just go maximum number of points, like let's say 75. So that I'm not crossing more than 32,000 number of nodes. So I'm just giving just 75 and click OK. So now we can able to see the entire circle has been split down into 75 smaller number of elements. So once you mesh it, so this particular 50 number of elements and then this 75 number of elements will be contributing and finding solving the mesh with respect to the nodal points. Then again click on mesh tool and then click on triangular mesh. So that will be easier whenever we are having a curved shape. If it is just a rectangular shape, then we can go with respect to the quad mesh. So here we're going with respect to the triangular mesh and then click on free and then click on mesh. Select the area to be meshed and click OK. Now we can able to see that the entire area has been meshed. So this meshing process has been taking place. Now we can able to see that the nearer to the hole there are maximum number of nodal points, and away from the nodes, away from the hole, we'll be having lesser number of nodal points. Okay. So next, go to plot, and by clicking on nodes, we can able to visualize the smaller number of nodal points. You can able to see there are a number of nodal points over here, so which is not crossing 32,000 number of nodes. Okay. So always keep in mind that you are using your free version, so it is limited with respect to 32,000 number of nodal points. So always give less number of nodal points. If you have a licensed version, then you can go with respect to lakhs and lakhs number of nodal points, which will capture the much more accurate results. Okay, so this is the meshing process is done. Next, we are going to the boundary condition. To go to the boundary condition, go to loads and click on define loads, apply structural displacement on lines. So select this entire line which you want to do the meshing process and click OK. Then click on all degrees of freedom and give the displacement value as 0 and then click OK. Now we can able to see that towards the left hand side of the plate, it is a fixed end. So it's been shown with respect to the both the sides, degrees of freedom has been fixed. But towards your right hand side, we have to give the load in the upward direction or the load in the downward direction. So depending upon our conditions, so the load has been applied either in the upward or downward direction. So here we are considering with respect to the upward direction. So we have to give the load in the upward direction. So here in ANSYS APDL, we cannot just give the load directly in the upward direction. First, we have to use this coupled degrees of freedom. So we call it as coupling equation. So go to coupling equation under preprocessor. So click on coupling and then click on coupled degrees of freedom. And after clicking on coupled degrees of freedom, go with respect to this option called box and then zoom in and select this entire box. So this is like a pan option. So pan towards your right. I'm just panning towards your right. So yeah, so we have to pan towards your left. So click a couple of times and until you get a proper view of it. Then select only the corner lines or the corner nodal points. Okay, so just select only the corner nodal points by clicking here, point outside the box and drag it and select only this particular points. So now you can able to see all the nodal points on the corner line or the free end has been selected and click OK. After clicking OK, give the set reference number as 1 and give the degrees of freedom or the location along your UY direction, so that is in the upward direction, and click OK. So now you can able to see that whatever the load you're applying, so all the nodal points over here has been combined as a single line. So you can able to apply the load in the upward direction. So you can just give fit to view. So this is fit view. Then everything will come and fix within the given screen. Then go to loads, define loads, apply structural displacement. Sorry, displacement we already given. Now we have to give the load in the upward direction. So go to force on nodes. Okay, so I'm giving the force on the nodes in the upward direction. So I click any one or two points on this particular line and click OK. So I'm going to give the load in the upward direction. So upward direction is nothing but y direction. So I'm going with respect to force along y direction. Fy represents force along y direction, and Fx represents force along x direction. So now I'm going to apply the force along y direction. So I give it as Fy, and then the constant value. So I consider some value. So let's say whatever the lift force or whatever the load acting on the particular plate we consider. So I'm just taking a constant value or some assumed value as 100 as the load in the upward direction, and click OK. Now we can able to see that the arrow mark is in the upward direction. You can able to see that the red color arrow mark is in the upward direction. So we can able to come to conclusion that the load is being applied in the upward direction. Once the load is applied in the upward direction, go to solution and then go to solve current load step. So why I'm doing this is, till now whatever I've given is like the loads or the boundary conditions, and then meshing I've done, and then I've made the modeling. So everything is done properly. Now I'm going to solve this problem. So whatever the given conditions are given, one end is fixed, the other end is free, and apply the load on the free end. So your deflection will be in the upward direction, and due to the deflection in the upward direction, the material properties, your Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio will be varying, and then you will be getting your change in stress concentration factor, or stress concentration factor where the maximum and minimum stress takes place at that particular nodal point. So that's what the stress concentration factor is all about. So we can able to find out the maximum stress concentration factor as well as the minimum stress concentration factor with respect to the governing equation. Then go to solve current LS. So click on this option, then the dialog box will come. So click solve current load step. Yes, click OK. Now it's been solving the entire problem with respect to the governing equation. So what is governing equation? At each and every nodal point, the governing equation will be taking place. So that is like all the governing equations of your stress, strain, and then other equations which we have learned through the equations or theory part. So those equations will be running behind the software and will give you the proper output. Then close this dialog box. So if you're getting solution is done, then whatever the boundary conditions, what are the preference you are given, everything is correct. If you are not giving it properly, then the problem won't have been solved. Okay, so the convergence has been done, so iteration is done. So next go to general post processor and click on read results last set. So I am doing this is because if you are doing more than 2-3 options, then we can able to visualize the last result, so last solved result. So that's what I'm going with respect to general post processor read results last set. After clicking this particular option, go to plot results counter plot. So I am going to counter plot because we have solved the entire problem or the flat plane with the center hole with respect to the nodal point. So the nodal points are the points which helps to visualize the stress concentration factor or the stress concentration point at that particular nodal point. So to visualize that, we are going with respect to counter plot and then nodal solution. After going to nodal solution, we'll be getting this particular nodal solution data. So the outputs, we can able to visualize all the outputs over here. So first I'm going with respect to the stress, and then click on von Mises stress. So why von Mises stress? Because von Mises stress is a stress which helps to identify the maximum stress and the minimum stress at a single point. So we can able to have three equations at this particular point, and then we can able to visualize the maximum stress of that particular point and then the minimum stress of that particular point. So if you want to go through much in depth, you can able to Google the video of von Mises stress, how does the stress has been taking place with respect to that. Okay, so that is what the von Mises stress is all about. Then click OK. Now we can able to see how does the output has been created. So we can able to see that the maximum stress is represented as the red color, and the minimum is been represented with respect to your blue color. So intermediate is been representing the lower to higher order terms of your stress range. Okay, so this is how we have to visualize the result. Okay, so now to visualize exactly where the maximum stress is all about, then we can able to animate this particular output. So to animate it, go to utility menu and click on plot controls, and then come to animate, and then click deformed results. Over there we have stress, and you just check it with respect to your y direction stress and click OK. Now we can able to see that the maximum stress has been taking place nearer to the hole. So this is the theory also states, whenever we are having a flat plate without a hole, the maximum stress will be taking place at the fixed end. But at the same time, for a cantilever beam, whenever we are having a hole with respect to the fixed end, okay, so there is a fixed end and there is a hole also, then we can able to say that due to the applied load, the maximum stress will be taking place nearer to the hole, not rather with respect to the fixed ends. This is because the wave which has been propagating from here has been opposed by this particular hole, and then maximum stress concentration has been converging over here. So that's what the maximum stress has been created over nearer to the hole, and then minimum to the fixed end. So since the load has been applied in the upward direction, we are getting maximum over here and over here. So over here it's been minimum. That's what the understanding we can able to consider from this particular diagram. Then close this dialog box. To save this output, if you save as it is, then you will be getting the background as black color. So if you're going with respect to your cartridge or a black and white printout, then this cartridge will be wasted. So to avoid that, we are going with respect to change this background color as white, so we can able to save the cartridge and we can able to get the proper output. To save in such fashion, go to plot controls, write meta file, and click invert white or black. After clicking invert white or black, then click on the folder where you want to save the file. So I'll just give it as desktop and give static structure analysis.
Okay, I thought you have understood very well how to do the analysis and how to just show the results from the applying the all the conditions through the analyze and after that showing the results. And at last but not least, audible. Okay, now I'm audible. I want to just response from your side. I am audible, no? Yes. So now you can see. So we'll go next. That is our one dimensional. What is the remaining problem? Last problem, no? In the thermal structural analysis, that problem we will start. Okay. So this is our problem 2D plate by using this analysis. We'll solve. So now you can see here, so we'll solve. Okay, so first of all, we'll see the problem and I will start the solving, okay. Okay, my screen is visible. Okay, so now you can see, we'll start that problem. Select the structural, okay. Click on the OK button. The next, preprocessing, then element type, add edit, add solid with the 4 node, not 42, quad 4 node, 182. Click on the OK. Then options, select the plane stress with thickness, plane stress. With thickness, plane stress with thickness, click on the OK button. Then the real constant and on the OK button. Okay, you click return the mouse close, material properties, then go to the material models, then go to the structural, linear, elastic, then isotropic, then Young's model values is 2E5, proximity value constant, that is the 0.3, which is given in our, all things given in our manual. You can just follow that manual, you will get to understand. Okay, click on the OK, exit. Then we have to model this actual model, then create modeling, then areas, then select rectangle, then by using key points. Okay, so here by two corners, by key points, then center corner by dimension, I think by two corners key points, and then we have to create the key point one first, x0 y0, then apply, then okay, I think some error, give me 1 minute. Key point option is here, rectangle by dimension. Okay, by dimension, then first x y1 0 y2 25. Okay, so next is click on the screen, then create areas, circle, then solid circle, then specify the radius 5 mm. Click on the okay. I think some, just give me 1 minute. Open ANSYS, click on the, again I will open ANSYS. Reference structural, okay. Element type, add edit, add solid, quad. Sorry, we need options, then plane stress to thickness, okay, close, then radial constant, add it, add, okay, thickness, same, click on the okay. Then set area and interesting or so you have to create by two corners, means first x1 we will try, x1, then 4p1 0, y2 0, apply. Okay, so x1, x2, what is the problem? Actually, the key point option is not there, so we have to go further. Okay, key points in QCS, first key point, then first x coordinate is 0, again y coordinate 0, apply. Second point, x is 40. Zero something is going to wrong, so because of that I can't be able to create the areas. Give me just 1 minute. Actually there is one option like key points in the toolbar is that anything I don't understand, but I will try. unit add solid chord option then thickness stress close then real constant add okay thickness 10 okay close material properties material models structural linear elastic isotropic five close modeling create areas rectangle already we have taken this by two corners I thought two corners okay no problem zero 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 apply not so this is also not by center two center zero zero apply this is also not working dimension so x x zero y zero and x 40 y 25 we'll try okay no problem zero zero and tick so create again we have to create areas then areas circle and solid circle so I have to create that circle in center so actually dimension is x how much 25 this is center and y center is 40 not exactly in between this I already taken 25 means 12.5 and here 20 and radius given in the problem I think 5 mm okay so I will keep as a 5 and apply again Okay, so again we'll see subtract areas. Click on the longer area. Click on the OK button. Then select the smaller area and click on the OK to subtract. But topological limits defined to modify geometry slightly. Okay, some problem is coming in that area, circle area section. So we will modify. Okay, give me cursor mode. Delete areas. Okay. So I think some software problem again coming. So we should stop here. Whatever that remaining part is there, that part. Okay. So whatever the this first one dimensional structural analysis problem is, that problem we will solve in next lecture. Okay, so whatever today we have learned thermal analysis problem, okay, and the structural analysis problem. So in next practical we will conclude that third and fourth practical, that is structural analysis and thermal analysis, with one example. Okay, and after that we'll start our second last practical, that is a programming on the CNC and CNC milling machine. Okay, so I thought we have to stop here.